starting the trip today. Looks like we're not doing anything for canoeing wise. We're just going, just jumping across the lake to a lean-to. We tried to get a site on Blue Mountain Lake, but it was all filled up because it's first come, first serve, so we didn't get that. Found a different place. We're actually bypassing a lot of canoeing for tomorrow and going right to Eagle Lake, so that's where we're staying today. They've already all headed down with the canoe. We had to do something in town, so now we're meeting back up. We're gonna hop in the canoe, paddle over to lean-to, hang out at the campsite, fish, and then tomorrow morning we'll be going like Marion Lake, doing the Marion Carry, and up into that lake where we're gonna camp on Tioga Point. Probably show some of the stuff of the campsite. Shuttle canoes over to our spot so that whenever we get out of the woods, we don't have to paddle back. So we can bring a little extra stuff this trip, but I think some members of the crew went a little overboard. But shall we go and just take a look of what we have over here? Pizza box, watermelon, a whole bag of charcoal. I hope that's legal. Is that an extra paddle? I suppose that's good, but
extra paddle.
Do you actually have pizza in here?
No, I'm just gonna burn the box. Please. Help start our charcoal fire.
I see. Well, starting off the trip glamping, I suppose. Well, so we're really suffering right now because we had to paddle all the way from over there. You can see it. It's really far away, but that shoreline. We paddled all the way over here. We've eaten corn and burgers. It's really rough. And then also just really scrimping over here. We got a lava cake just that got made right there. So really suffering. It really sucks out here.
Just woke up like an hour or so ago. We're all caught up at like 6:30-ish. We've eaten breakfast. My dad and Garrett are all gonna go across the lake there, get to the vans, shuttle the canoes up to Fork Lake Campground, and then come back with the car. And then we're all gonna meet up canoe to Racket and camp on Tioga Point. Not a very big day today either, so it's pretty laid back. Yeah, we all slept decent. Mosquitoes were terrible last night. They calmed down. It got a little chillier because it was pretty hot in the morning. I gotta filter some water. Pond water is pretty scummy towards the shore, but we're all doing pretty good. Feel pretty rested, so looking forward to today.
So we just found a ginormous snapping turtle.
The other guys coming with their car, so we took off heading towards the Marion Carry. I think we can see the portage marker up ahead. I think from what we know, it's like 0.3 of a mile, maybe half a mile at the most. We have a little paddle on Racket, and then we're camping at Tioga Point. So we pushed off.
Doug, there he is.
The boys we sent off on an excursion alone.
They're that away,
proving themselves as men.
So, and the other guys are catching up in the Grunman, so we'll probably see them at the portage. So at the end of this Utawana Lake, there's like this little curve here. I think it's kind of the start of the Marion River, and then we're gonna get to that carry not too long. There's a lot of signs talking about no motorboats because of invasive species. Just got to the end of the Marion Carry, or got to where the Marion Carry is, and it wasn't far at all from where we were at Utawana at that lean-to. So
where the carry is pretty nice. Looks like it's got like an actual nice dock. So the carry is actually an old railroad bed. So also there's a bass. So there's fish in here. We saw bluegill and sunfish and bass, and heard about a perch too. So I guess we'll check in the middle of the carry or towards the end.
Well, so we're doing the Marion Carry. Like I said, it's not very far. So we're just double carrying it. I got my pack and we got some other stuff. I mean, this really isn't, we're not short for time.
and it's a short carry. He's carrying a paddle and a few bags. He is carrying his bag and fishing pole, I think, and his paddle. So we'll just come back for the canoe, swap on and off carrying it, I reckon. Yeah, so trail looks actually really nice, as you can see, really smooth. So the guys behind me rigged up on the Grunman wheel system. So they're got one guy wheeling it, and I think out of all the portages we'll be doing, this is probably the best one, because barely even Rudy was still on the Marion carry. You got, you're basically carrying across this creek here, bypassing that, and then back into where it widens out, because obviously you can't paddle that, it'd be a little difficult. Log in the way right in front of me here, so they'll have to deal with that. We'll see how this portage ends. Just coming to the end of the portage, and just the whole carry is pretty simple. Like, honestly, those roots right there are the worst of the whole hike, and it's very dry. So anybody that's done the portage is often, it's super wet and muddy, but that was no problem. Also for roots, it was not bad at all, and super flat. Honestly, one of the nicest looking portages I've ever done, I think. And then it gets to you to this, which looks kind of shallow. We should be able to avoid hitting those rocks, but still super pretty, but not a hard portage at all. Again, I mean, the shove-off point is pretty good, too, and pretty free rock. It's a lot of sand, so also super nice. On my GPS, it says there was about 0.33 for the trip there. Not very far at all. One thing to note, often you can use Avenza. It's a free app. You can download different maps from there. Some of them are paid. Some of them are free. The one that I'm using for the Adirondacks is the Adirondack Physical. It doesn't show you docking points or, like, fishing spots like some do or lean-tos, but it just gives you, like, a rough topo, gives you all the maps of the lakes and stuff, and some roads. It might be a little outdated, but that's what I'm using for this trip. It works well, so Avenza is a good free option. It's only accessible by boat, but definitely pretty civilized. Like, there's other people here. My tent's not too far apart from each other. But Jared's here, Jordan's here, Andy and I got here. Really bright and sunny out. Jordan, Riley, and Dad are right there. It was about 6 miles from that Marion portage, like where we entered it. Sorry, where we got out of the portage to where we are now, from what I tracked. I feel like the Marion River started off really slow, and then towards the end it felt a lot faster. Maybe that's just because it was mined, or it was easier or straighter on the map. Like the other earlier was more zigzaggy. You know, we're gonna settle in. It's 2:44 now. We left at like 10:30, so we're just gonna chillax here, see what we run into for interesting things to do. I know there's talk of making a soup tonight out of some vegetables and stuff that we packed out, so looking forward to that. Well, we've made camp. You can see we got some of our tents up, just got out of the water. We played chickens, which was pretty fun. Well, we have just been kind of lounging around. It's been pretty nice. Now Chef PD, Beware PD, is cooking up some soup, looking like he's gonna share with all of us. It's pretty nice of him. Yeah, it's pretty chill today. We're just gonna hang out and then do Riley's little ceremony, and then bing, bang, boom, turn in for the evening.
Well, we've all woken up and breakfast. Now we're tearing down camp. It's 6:45. We all got up a little before 6. It's like 5:30. And we're trying to beat the early boats because here on the Tioga Point, there's boat access for like pontoons, speedboats, and motorboats. A lot of people are out and the wakes are quite annoying on a canoe. So we're trying to get up early, get going before those jackalegs, and then also trying to beat the wind because the wind is probably not going to get any better. So we're trying to get a good start. We're trying to get to Fork Lake before too late because we still got to drive home. Yeah, we got a good day ahead of us. I think it's like 9 miles or just shy of 9 miles. So I'll still map it out and be able to tell you what the whole trip was. Yesterday was about 6 miles. We left at like 10:30. Got here at 3-ish. So we'll see how we do today and what time we get in. The route is we're going up this Racket River, getting to around Woods, and then we're taking a portage up to Fork Lake. And then we paddle across Fork Lake to get to Fork Lake Campground where the boat access is, and we're going to do the car switches. We are docking up, getting ready to go. It is 7:22. We're just getting all the boats in the water. The water is kind of choppy, but it could be worse, so we're hoping it doesn't sink any. Next stop is the Racket portage, I think, or at least the Racket to Fork Lake portage. So we're towards the end of Racket Lake, just got to that little where it narrows up and it kind of turns into a river. Some people flagged us down and showed us where the carry is. Really easy to miss. So if you see that bridge, I don't know if you see that on the camera, but there's a bridge. Well before the bridge, there's a carry by this cottage right here. So you get through that little, there's that little pinch point right there, and really not too far off to the left is right where that carry is, so just something to know. So we're at the carry. Path just doesn't even look right. This doesn't look like it should be a portage. I think it's half a mile. Made it back to the car, got loaded up with stuff, made it to the Tioga Point campsite. I got them all checked in, and now we're just loading stuff in the car.